afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, sir, and very good afternoon to all. Today we all are gathered here on this virtual platform, virtual media, to learn something interesting. Hereby I welcome you all, principal, our HODs, the participants and all the dignitaries in today's session. Today's session is all about what should be chosen as a career, entrepreneurship or job. And it is a very interesting topic and important topic as well as for all the students. So without any delay, I would like to welcome our today's speaker, Komal ma'am, on behalf of Parul Polytechnic Institute, Parul University. Welcome, Komal ma'am. To give a quick introduction about her, I would like to say that she is a founder of Nanosoft and App IT Solution, which provides needs of software for clients in India as well as many other countries like Japan, USA, Germany, UK and many others. She is also provides a free consultant too. And I must say she is a young entrepreneur with a positive mindset. So without any delay, I would like to start our today's session. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Nidhi, and thank you, Hutesh, for giving me the opportunity to bring about the Nanotech Soft App in front of the Parul University and all of the students who are thinking whether to become an employee or an entrepreneur. And thank you, Parul University team, to arrange all this virtual webinar. We all know in COVID-19 and in this corona situation, lockdown, everyone is facing a lot of challenges, how to bring business, how to interact with the students, how to interact with the teachers, and even in healthcare as well. And this is, I think, a virtual platform is a great platform if you want to share anything and want to run everything in this environment. This is a great platform. So today's what topic has been decided. So this is what I can say. This is the most crucial part of anyone's life. When someone is graduating from the college and he is facing a lot of challenges and all the dilemma in mind, what to choose, whether to become an employee or become an entrepreneur. Both these segments have a different journeys and have their own challenges. And different lifestyles, money, everything is different. I would like to share my screen first and then I'll be starting on the presentation. Yes. When someone is graduating from the college, then there are a lot of questions in his person mind, what to choose. Either I should go that way, this way, there is a wrong way, right way, what is a hard way, what is the easy way. Everyone is confused. This is not a confusion while graduating or after graduation. This is a situation we face in everyday's life, everyone's life. What to choose? I want to do hard work or I don't want to do hard work. What path I should choose? And today we are talking about what to choose, job or entrepreneurship. I can say from my own journey, entrepreneurship is a hard way, but employment is also a hard way, but not that much. Entrepreneurship is not a right way for someone. Entrepreneurship is a right way for someone, but you have to totally decide what's your passion. You don't need to follow anyone. Don't follow, please. It's my personal request. If you follow your parents, your friends, or anyone in your network, you will not be able to decide what to choose. And someday in your life, you will feel like I have made a wrong decision. Or might be you will be saying, I have made a right decision. Totally depends where you want to reach. When I started, I didn't follow anyone. I was thinking from my own. I was researching. But what my soul said, Komal, you should become an entrepreneur. Because since my childhood, I used to think innovative, from my sixth standard when I think and when I connect dots of my life. I think like at sixth standards, I was thinking something innovative. In seventh standard and so on. Even when I started my job, then I was thinking something different, innovative. And today, at this point of time, when I connect that dots, I can see I'm in a like my life is for to bring some innovation to my customers, to myself, for everyone. Because entrepreneur is not someone who is there for money. Entrepreneur is someone who can take risk and bring innovation and can help others. What I said, you should follow your passion. Now, it's not a one-day job. You can't you can't judge what's your passion at one day. You have to do daily homework. You have to try multiple tasks. You have to try lot of things. How to try that? Just try, do something today. And if that doesn't work, then try another thing, another day. Keep on continuing that thing. And then one day, might be, that can be after 6 months, might be, that can be after 1 year. But one day, you can see my wall behind me. It's hard work plus consistency plus time is equal to results. That is the life of the entrepreneur. If you want to consistent in your life, if you want to do hard work, and if you have a time, you want to give time for yourself to achieve your dreams, you have to follow your passion. Now, what I said, you have to be consistent. Consistent, I can say, I told you, my passion is bring some innovation. That innovation can't come in a one day. You have to work daily. Bring some idea, have some idea, work on it. If it doesn't work, put that in a diary, note it down, and then close the diary, work on something other. Again, if that doesn't work, you will see you are learning a lot. That is the entrepreneur life. Every point you have to learn. You can't regret. You have to learn, you have to learn, you have to learn. You have to learn from your failures. You can't say, or you don't have an excuse, if I am failing, I can't become an entrepreneur. That is a time, if you are consistent, even after your failure, you are in this life to become an entrepreneur, if that is your passion. Entrepreneur works on ideas. We have seen lot of entrepreneurs in the market. Lot of. Every day, we read the stories on your story. Something I can say, biryani by kilo. What is this? This is like small thing, like biryani. Everyone eats. But what's the difference? They brought that biryani in handi. And that was a unique concept. They're not solving a big problem. They're giving a better service because customer or their users wants to eat in a handi. Because that time, जो हमारे दादी नानी के जमाने में चलते थे और वो हम आज इस एरा में लेके आए हैं. वी आर कंबाइनिंग दैट बिरयानी एंड द हांडी. दैट्स अ इनोवेशन. फ्लिपकार्ट बुक्स वी यूज टू ब्रिंग एट आवर होम फ्रॉम द शॉपकीपर फ्रॉम द स्टेशनरी. देन हाउ इट इज डिफरेंट. दे आर गिविंग और दे आर सेलिंग द बुक्स ऑनलाइन. That's an innovation, right? Food delivery. There is nothing new in that. You could take that delivery of your food. If you want to eat anything, you can go to the shop. You can take and eat at your home. But so what's the difference? What's the innovation? What's the unique? they are giving that food at your home without any additional cost. Sometimes they apply the additional cost because that's a logistic charges. That's not something in their service. That is called something different or something unique. All that comes once you follow your passion. All that comes when you are consistent and hard work and you are giving that time for yourself. That is the innovation. And that is who is an entrepreneur. Now, we have talked a lot about the entrepreneurship. We have to be consistent. We have to be give the time and we have to do the hard work. We can earn a lot. Our lifestyle is different. Then this is a question we have everyone's today. Entrepreneur or employee? I want to ask everyone, what do you want to do? Become employee or entrepreneur? What? It totally depends on your passion. It totally depends on your interest. You want to choose hard way or easy way, wrong way or right way. Again, questions comes to my first slide. All these slides are interconnected. All these strategy are interconnected. Now, I can show in my slide entrepreneur versus employee. You can see the salary of the employee who is doing a job and it's like good amount of money he is earning every month. Everyone is getting the money, even he's not doing anything. Sometimes we do. In business, I can see from Jan, $2,500 I was earning. In Jan, being in a business, I was not earning anything, zero. Even I'm spending on my employees. I was spending indirect expenses, direct expenses, lot of. How to bring that money? I have to ask from my parents. I have to ask from my friends or anyone in my network who can help me. But in job, every day you are earning, every month you are earning, every year you are earning. But at the end of, if I had taken the data of 1 year, in job, I could earn at the end of December, like if I make it total and in December, I take an example of December month, my income $2,500. But when I see the difference, when I was doing the business or being after that my entrepreneurship, I could earn $6,000. I had started at $2,500, still I'm earning $25 in the job. But in business, I was earning $0 in January and the spike, big hike, $6,000 in December. But in August, you can see, I was earning $400 from zero to 1,000 in July and then again down $400. In August, in job, I was earning $2,500, same amount. There's a lot of difference I could see. Income difference. Now, I'll talk about entrepreneur or employee. Being an employee, you don't have a freedom. No freedom to take your own decisions. But on the right side, when I am entrepreneur, I am on your own boss. I can take my decisions. I have a rights on everything. No one can stop me. On the left-hand side, when I see being an employee, lifestyle, monotonous. There is no something I'm bringing innovative. Sometimes I'll do, but most of the times, I don't know. Totally depends in which organization I'm working. Lifestyle on the right-hand side, being an entrepreneur, every day is different. Every day. It's not like you will be traveling and you will be having a pub, drinks every day. It's not a lifestyle in entrepreneur's life. It's totally different. I will show how it is different. Don't think it is like every day I'm enjoying because I have a lot of money. No. Income. Being an employee, my income is fixed and stable income. I could show you in my last slide. Every month I was earning $2,500. On the right hand side, unlimited income potential. But sometimes I was not earning anything, $0. But sometimes I was earning $6,000. That is much greater than what I was earning in the December when I was employed. Workload. Being employed, I do have a limited workload. I can say to my boss, this is 9-to-5 job. I can do more because I'm doing a job. In workload, as an entrepreneur, I have to work, or I might have to work 80 to 90 hours a week. Huge difference. In employment, I was doing, if I talk about 8 hours a day and 5 days a week, 40 hours. But entrepreneur, 80 to 90 hours a week. You can see there is almost doubles difference. You're not earning anything in January and you're doing 80 to 90 hours of work a week. Why? I'm not earning, still I'm working. I'm earning, being employed, still I'm limited or working. You can see the difference. There's a lot of tweaks, and we have to understand if you want to become an entrepreneur, like how it is different, why it is different, and how we can make it totally different for others, for us, for our families, for our friends, and everyone who is related to me, who is related to everyone in my country. This is an entrepreneur who is a leader, who brings innovation, who has a lot of knowledge, who is doing a business, who is a risk tolerance and assertiveness. He is handling a team as well. Innovation. I already told you like how we can bring innovation. Being consistent, think out of the box. If it is not working, don't feel failure. Note it down on your notebook and keep it safe. In future, I can say, or I'm sure, that idea, you will be working again, because that is the idea totally related to and touched to your heart. And that will work, because every time in entrepreneurship, you have to think assertiveness. You have to think positive. How you can think, who can think positive? How you should think? I am a risk tolerant person. I can take risk. No matter I am earning zero or I am earning $6,000. I was taking the risk when I was earning $0 in the month of Jan. I can take risk when I was earning $6,000 per month. Then if I am earning a lot, why am I taking the risk? Because that's my job. Being an entrepreneur, I have to take the risk. I should have a lot of knowledge because I want to bring innovation. I want to grow my business. And there's a difference between the business and entrepreneur. I'm opening a shop. I take an example. I opened that small shop for tea. I am giving that tea in disposal cup. That's my business. Being an entrepreneur, I opened same shop, but instead of giving that tea in a disposal cup, I brought that tea in a cooler, that mitti one we used to take in the market. So that is a cooler. There is a startup in Bangalore who brought same idea. Instead of selling that tea in a disposable cup or that like kaach ka cup, he brought that tea in cooler. I could see he was engaging lot of customers. Everyone was coming to him, not just because he wants, that customer wanted a tea. He wanted a tea in a kullad. That's an entrepreneur. That's a something innovation. He was not following that crowd. He was not following like what others are doing. He was following what innovation he can bring. In a big market, he brought something different. He's an entrepreneur. Although he didn't have a much knowledge, might be, but there can be the chance. Totally depend what kind of the business you are running. If I want to open something like a Flipkart, I should have a lot of knowledge, all operational knowledge, logistic knowledge, everything. But if I want to open a tea shop, being in a Kullad, then I should have a knowledge, but not that much. I can do a lot of things and learning day by day that we can do. This is a life of the entrepreneur. There's a lot of excitements every day. A lot of things will be working and some are not. Totally messed up. Give up the good for the great. You have to compromise these things. To bring something different, you have to compromise. You can think or you will be going bankrupt. I am good. I don't know why I get so down in my life. I was wrong. I was suck. Wait a second, my life is great. You could see there's a spikes, like up and down spikes in this graph. Totally different. You can't judge being an entrepreneur, what will be my next day, how it will be like goes on, and what's my today. You can't expect. That is an entrepreneur. Now, I talked about knowledge. How you can bring the knowledge? Just after the graduation, you can't have a lot of knowledge. There can be the chance, I can say, from my experience, 1-2% people in your whole college or any network, you can have good amount, ample of knowledge. But sometimes we don't have. So I would suggest, don't go for entrepreneurship just after college. You can go, but totally depends how you judge yourself, how you analyze yourself, how you follow your passion, you are consistent, you want to do hard work, or you have a time, you have to think. There's a process of thinking as well. Take a notebook, bring pen, note down everything. Make your goal settings. Then work on that daily basis. Don't go in a one day. There's a big risk. And now you will say, entrepreneur will be taking a risk. But that risk should be in an intelligent way. It's not like, that my like cousin brother, my parents are saying your cousin brother became an entrepreneur just after college. There can be the chance, but you have to think as per your things. You have to analyze yourself. If you can do, you should do. If you can't, take your time. Have patience. Be consistent. Do hard work. Now, I would suggest go for get a job in a good company where you can learn a lot. And sometimes when we go for interviewer used to ask some common question. What's your passion? What do you want to do? How you will do? You don't have a knowledge. Knowledge not in terms of your like passion, knowledge in terms of your skill set. Like you are a developer and you don't know C. He will say, you don't know C, you should brush up your skills. Now you will say, being a fresher, I don't know anything, but you should have basics. If you have a basics, then interviewer will surely appoint you. And now, like, what to say, job. So you should grab that job, and the like employer will ask, or interviewer will ask, how much you expect from us. You will say X amount. Then employer or interviewer will say, no, you are the fresher. We can't give you that much. Your question, your answer will be. So that usually happens, I can say, from my experience. Like you will say, my cousin brother or my friend, he's earning a big amount of money. Just after graduation, he's also fresher. Why is he getting? There can be the chance. Again, totally depends on the environment. You can't judge what others are doing. You can't judge what they are doing. You have to analyze. Again, I am focusing on, you have to analyze yourself. Be your own. Don't follow all others. Be a passionate person. Then you will say, yes, I want to be the entrepreneur, but before becoming an entrepreneur, you have to get a knowledge. How that knowledge will come? You will answer to the employer or the interviewer, sir, give me job. I want to learn. Just learn. If you say, like, I'm not giving money to you, that's fine with me. But give me something where I can survive myself. I have 5-6K, whatever, what sorts of money you need. Then he will say, he might give more than that, because he will judge, yes, this person is not asking money. He or she is asking a knowledge. I will give her knowledge or him knowledge. I should give her or him some good amount, because she is here to learn. If she will be learning, we can grow. We can work on good number of projects. Eventually, we'll be earning and we'll be growing. Then why don't we start giving good amount of money to this person? See, from your saying only, he could give ample amount of money being a fresher only. If you ask, sir, I need this amount of money, he will never give. Totally depends on the situation. Again, I am focusing, totally depends on the situation. Make your pitch according to the environment. Make your understanding as per the environment. Everything works as per the environment. Yes, this is an entrepreneur. Being an entrepreneur, you have to wear lot of hats. Lot of hats. If I was searching a job, then I will say I'm a developer. Then why go for sales? I am a salesperson. Why should I go for marketing? I am hired for the marketing. Then why should I hire the team? Why I want to become, I will be the like HR. But in entrepreneurship, you can't say. You have to. Wear lot of hats, strategic hat, finance hat, sales hat, client relationship hat, human resources hat, and the manager hat, and a lot. You have to become a pantry boy. You have to become a watchman. You have to run. You can't say, I'm the entrepreneur, I'm my own boss, I can't do anything. There are a lot of entrepreneurs in the market who have done these shitty jobs. And they're successful today because they didn't say, this is a small job. This is not for me. No, you can't say being an entrepreneur. Right. So while you do the like employment, like job, you learn one thing, but if it is your passion or it's your goal to become an entrepreneur, you have to learn a lot. I can say from my experience, I started my career as a developer because, like as I told you, I wanted to become something different or entrepreneur in my life one day. And this is like my journey has been started. And I am wearing a lot of hats. And when I started my career as a developer, then I thought that something came from my heart. Like, commonly, you have to become an entrepreneur. You have to learn a lot. You have to struggle. You have to face the challenges. You have to take the risk as well. Then what I did, after the development, I used to learn functional part. I used to learn business functions, business strategies, like from my own, from Google, from my network. I used to go in meetups groups to meet the entrepreneurs, to grow my network, and I did a lot of things. My parents didn't know where Komal is going when she's coming. From 6 in the morning till 9 to 10 in the night, I was out of my home because I was doing a job. I was learning a lot. I was taking the courses, lot of things I did. And today when I think, yeah, I am connecting the dots, I did that. That's learning I want to share everyone who wants to do the employment or who wants to do the become an entrepreneur. This is like a connecting dots, and these are like the phases you have to brought in your life. You have to learn a lot. You have to be dynamic. And there's one strong word in a like dictionary I can pick, dynamic. You have to be the dynamic. You can't say I'm the entrepreneur, I can do sales. You have to do the sales. You have to be the finance person. You have to interact with the customer. You have to get the requirements. And you have to bring the innovation. Then you will say one day, yes, I am the entrepreneur. This is what me. I'm not doing anything. No matters. One day, if I am consistent, I am doing the hard work, and I'm giving the time to myself, I will be the entrepreneur and I will earn one day ample amount of money because I followed my passion. What I could judge from this picture when I was searching, this is an employee. Now you will be thinking, when talking about you should be the entrepreneur, you have to do the job, why? Why she's like tweaking all around? I'm confused. My audience is, I think, confused. You're whether to go for employment or entrepreneurship. Again, I will tell you, everything is correlated. Being an entrepreneur, you have to wear a lot of hats. To wear a lot of hats, there should be have good amount of knowledge. How to get that knowledge? You have to do the job. What job? Where you can learn a lot instead of getting the money, right? You have to hard work like this person. This person is doing a job 24 hours a day. He's not thinking, I am earning X amount of money and I have to do 9-to-5 job. I have seen from my, when I was doing a job, I have seen a person who wanted to learn. After office hours, he did extra work. He used to learn softwares or tools, whatever he wanted to do. He was doing the things from his own. And today, that person is earning a lot, being an entrepreneur, being in his business. That's what anyone can expect when he wants to become an entrepreneur. You can't say to your boss, sir, you are giving this much of money, I can do more. Then you can't do entrepreneurship. You will be employed throughout your whole life. You will not be making any decisions. You can't be make because you will not have decision-making skills. You'll be earning same amount of money every month. Might be you'll be getting more after switching the job. But every day, you will be doing the same thing. You will not be facing that much of challenges what entrepreneurs face. So do hard work, be consistent, follow your passion, give your time, and for your like bring something innovative in front of everyone, then you will not saying I am the entrepreneur. Everyone will say you are the entrepreneur. Thank you.
Ma'am, there are some questions from the students. The one question is that what should be the characteristics if you want to choose as a career as an entrepreneur after the graduation?
Characteristics of like for the person or related to this terminologies?
Terminologies.
Can you please repeat the question once?
Someone want to do the pursue as a career as an entrepreneur. Okay.
Okay.
So what should be her his or her characteristics? So for our same terminology.
Yes. So I think that I have covered in this like presentation. Again, like I can say, he have to talk to his heart. He have to talk to his soul, and then analyze. Like what is coming from my heart, note it down, then analyze, brought that points what you have written, work on that iteratively, like daily work on that, and then think. And when you will be working on that points, even while sleeping, you will be thinking, yes, I am working on this point, I want to do a job. From that points only, you will be getting the result. Yes, I want to do job or become an entrepreneur. You have to judge yourself. You are a passionate person. If yes, tick mark. You want to do hard work, tick mark. You can face the challenges, tick mark. You can take risk, tick mark. You can work. Do a hard work 24 hours a day. If you're not working, even tick mark. So these are the small characteristics to become an entrepreneur. Again, there are a lot of points. Follow other entrepreneurs, how they started. There are a lot of entrepreneurs in a market who started just after the college dropout because they had tick marked all these characteristics in their diary or in their soul or in their heart. That's way they become an entrepreneur and they're earning good amount of money. They have dignity in front of everyone. Everyone knows, right? Yeah. I hope I answered your question.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Ma'am, one student having the question that suppose I'm choosing the career as employment. Okay. I'm getting the good salary of like from this some standard companies. Okay, then why we choose the career as an entrepreneur? Suppose I'm getting the second option also then.
So I just repeat your question. So someone is asking like I'm doing a job, I'm earning a handsome money, handsome salary. Then why should choose a entrepreneur?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So. There are a lot of cases I have seen from my experience, from my network. Like recently I met one person. He said like, Komal, I was working in a like big organization. I was earning handsome money. I dropped that. I become an entrepreneur. Then why? How does that motivation came from like in him? Because he had tick marked all that points. He didn't want to work for a money. He wanted to work for the passion. He wanted to solve some problem. He wanted to take the risk and he wanted to change his life. Instead of running, you can work in employment or in a job. You can earn billions. You can earn same money or more than that money in entrepreneurship. But in job, again, you will be having a same lifestyle every day. And you will be feeling someday boring. It totally depends on the individual. Some people like to enjoy that they are doing same work every day. some people don't enjoy. Like, why I'm doing the same work? I'm for this, like doing the same work every day, duplicate work. I don't enjoy personally. If someone says, Komal, this task repeatedly, you have to work for 1 month or 2 months, I will say no. I need something different. I get bored because that is my whole soul. I can't do same repetitive work again and again. I need something different. I try to bring something different, not like a big different, something which motivates me. Yeah, today I have brought something new. Let's work on it. Let's change my mindset. Let's brainstorm the things. I have when I in 6th standard and in 10th standard, 12th standard, even my graduation, my high school, lot of ideas used to come in my mind. I wrote that points. I have my diary where I have written lot of ideas. When I want to work or when I want to bring something new, I used to bring that diary. I used to think on that ideas. And I can see that a lot of innovations are there in that diary, which I brought from myself. No one taught me Komal, this is the idea, work on it. No, there can be a time, but a lot of ideas are mine. And I used to bring that in front of I will be bringing one day all that ideas in form of some solutions to my customers or to my market. And that is the entrepreneur. So bring something different and work on that. Right? I hope I answered this question.
Yes, I think student got the answer, man. Okay, Aman, I am having one question. That suppose the someone our previous year students also having some ideas. Okay, the ideas are getting every day they are getting the new ideas. Okay, but somehow the ideas are not working properly. Okay, so the student will get demotivated. So how to get motivated even if a failure several times?
Yes, I think I covered that point in my slides. Failure is something for entrepreneur. If you can say I'm the failure, means that synonym is you are the entrepreneur. There are a lot of entrepreneurs, watching that videos of the Ankur, that founder of the Nearby, right? He started, it is his third startup, that nearby.com. He started with secondshadi.com. He got failed. He worked on some other idea. He got failed, I think. And then he started on a nearby.com and he got successful. Today he's presenting everyone his failures, his learnings in form of the videos. And he's presenting that videos to those who wants to become an entrepreneur. He's sharing his failures. So you can't say, or you can't judge the person who is doing a good, who is an entrepreneur today and has not been a failure any time. You will see, bring all the case studies and you analyze he was a failure. And today he's an entrepreneur because he has learned from the failures. So I would suggest if that ideas are not working, means there are two things. Either idea is not good or that is then not a time of the idea to bring in a solution, to bring in a market. So I told you, write down that idea in a notebook and close that notebook. Again, make your mind fresh, do some motivation. Again, in entrepreneurship, you have to do the motivation or meditation. You have to be the inspirational. You have to be motivated. These three things you have to bring in your life. Every day for at least 1 hour, do the meditation. I can assure you, when you said, lot of students are working on idea and they're not able to get the answers or they're not able to bring in a solution. And they're not able to convert that ideas into the product. Then So fresh your mind and do the meditation again. Your mind will be relaxed and again work on something, think something different. And I can assure you, you will bring some more ideas. Again, start working on that. You will fail. You will feel failure. Not that that in a notebook. Again, start something new, another day. And this is iterative process. You can convert that your idea into the product in first attempt. Sometimes what happens, you can't do even our 10 attempts or 100 attempts. You have to be consistent. So don't feel demotivated. It will happen. And that is a nature. If you are able to attempt if you are able to succeed in your first idea after the first attempt, there can be a 99% chances you will be the failure, because you have not learned from your success. You can only learn from your failure. So that is a good thing if you are not able to bring that idea into the product, because you are learning from the failure. I have worked on so many ideas, many stages I have reached, but I could see that ideas were not for me. Since my graduation, just after my graduation, when I started my first job, I used to work on an idea. And then I used to consult with my mentors. I used to consult with my friends, anyone in my network who has a good knowledge. I used to go to the networking sessions, meetup network. I used to learn. I used to follow other entrepreneurs, not business person, but entrepreneurs. I used to take the points from their good, like what they're thinking, which is attracting me. I used to note down that. I used to follow that. Not exactly, but something which is useful for me. So again, I will say, don't follow others blindly. Have the brainstorming, think about it, and then work on it. I hope answers is there.
Yes, ma'am. Next question is that suppose ki someone want to start their startup, okay, and I think he or she is having everything available for her. So, he or she should be joined first as a job, or she will be directly go to as a for her startup. As okay. Everything is available in market, like office is available, client is available. But as you mentioned earlier, that someone having knowledge, then he can, after getting the knowledge or after joining the some their companies, then after that he or she could be joined as a should be start as a startup. Okay, so what do you think? Should we directly join job or go to the as a everything is available for as an entrepreneur?
Okay, so there are two things. One thing, whether he can take the risk. So that person have to judge. I can take the risk. I can, whatever I have, like money, market, my customers, I put that on a stakes without have a good amount of knowledge, or even that person have. That only depends on the individual. I can put them on a stakes, then I should start. There's one thing. Another thing, if that person says 99% I'm sure, 1% I'm confused and I have doubt, then that person should start with a job, and parallelly he can start with some part-time work. And then that person will think like, I'm doing a good job, I'm earning a handsome amount of money, then I'm doing good as well here, serving my clients, and I'm taking the risk as well. Then you have to put that on same level and see what on higher level. If you will say like, I am bring some innovation, and I am making my customers happy, I'm earning good amount of money, not as compared to my job, but good amount of money. Now this is a time I can start full time. Then bring that above. Stop the job. But if you say, I'm on this level and I'm not able to judge what to start, then start with this. then if you'll say, yeah, I'm doing good, but my this one is going down, my passion is there, have this one. Then there is a level. Bring that level in between those.
Okay, I think then student will got the answer. Then the last question is that, is it necessary to have a mentor in any startup, like a technical or non-technical?
So there should be, there should sometimes or most of the times there should be. They are the mentors who in a market bucket again. Mentor, there's a lot of mentors, but you have to analyze which mentor you need. You need strategy maker, you need non-functional, you need technical. What sort of mentor you need? You'll say, I'm a good in a technical, but I can't make the strategy. Then brought some mentor who can build the strategy for you. You will say, I'm some sort of good in technical. I can make the strategies. Then what is good? Bring someone who can do both, who have good knowledge and had done a lot of startups and her mentorship knowledge brought him. It will say, if you will say like I'm 100% sure and I can do what sort of challenges I will face, I don't need any mentor, then again, you are wrong. Don't say I don't need anyone. You need someone who can guide you. Not every time, but sometime. Because being a human being, we can't decision 100, we can't take 100% decisions at our own. You need some sort of mentor. And so totally depends like how he is guiding. If he's not able to guide you in a proper manner, he's not able to make the strategies for you, stop that mentorship. Either look for some other one or bring your own ideas. Till that point of time, you have learned a lot. You could see, I can make the strategies. I'm doing a good. Totally depends on situation to situation. But I will say, try to bring the mentors in areas where you are weak. I hope I answered my question again.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Exactly. Ma'am, can we take one last question?
Sure.
One of the question is like how to get a financial support from as a startup or suppose key someone want to start something. So how to get the financial support as a, or from where to get the financial support as a, earlier as a startup?
Sure. Yeah. It's not a doubt like we don't need a money. When we want to start something, we need a money. And I can say, yeah. So there are a lot of things are connected with each other. First, if you don't have a money, you don't want to go for a job, but and your family is doing a support, ask money from your family, your friends or relatives. If you're getting the money, that's good. You are lucky. And if they say, no, we don't believe on you, we don't have a belief on you, and do some good job, get earning, and then start something. You will say, no, I want to start now. Then it's all about the luck again. Second step. I can say that parallel part, it's your luck. Have some idea. Again, ideas don't get funding much. The lot of, that's again, 0.1% of your luck. You will get funding on ideas from like pre-seed funding you can get, but there's a less chance and a lot of risk as well. I can say when we started on our product, I got one mentor and I after working with him for 2 months, I could see he's not helping me a lot. Then he tried to help me to make a pitch because he taught me like Komal gets for the funding on ideas base only. Then after my research, I could see on ideas, if I go for funding, there are a lot of risk and I will not be the owner of my product or my idea. Then why do we are doing a lot of things? if I'm not 100% authority of my product, of my startup, then why I'm putting all my hard work, all my money, right? Then we stopped that mentorship and we started bootstrap. Again, how I got that money from the for the bootstrapping. I did the job for 9 to 10 years and I saved all these things because I wanted to become an entrepreneur. So again, bootstrapping we did. For my complete product, that Neom PMO, and this is something project management tool which we have recently launched. And what I can say, this is a product which is, I can say, not a cloning of any project management tool in the market. I am the PMP certified, and I do have knowledge in the development and in project management as well. I could bring all my failures, all my experiences into that product. I have given the demos, since this is a recently released, I have given the demos to Australian people, that US and Germany. And they have really appreciated that product because I could brought the value to my customers, value to the project managers, their team, and the risk they are facing in the projects, that could I bring in my product. As this is not a cloning of any product, this is again from the experiences I could brought. That's why I'm thinking like I'm getting appreciated. This is again the bootstrapping, and again, funding. Bootstrapping, again, bootstrapping your own, bootstrapping from your relatives, for your families, getting the funding, or the angel investors. But again, if you want to the bootstrap, if you're not getting the money from your network, then I think you should do a job, good job, where you can earn a lot. You can, if you are ready to give that time to your startup, brought that money, then invest that money. Don't take risk in hurry. Be patient, and then slowly, slowly, parallelly, you can work on that ideas, because ideas can't be implemented into the solutions in a one day. You have to do the market research. You have to do the product research. You have to bring the prototypes. You have to try with the development. Then you will judge like whether my ideas are working or not. Again, show that ideas prototype to your some customers. Show that I have this idea. I'm trying to solve this problem. And then either you are appreciating or not. When I started with this product, I showed that ideas or features which I wanted to put in my prospective customers. They said, yeah, this is a good solution we can build. Then only I started. When I was working on some other ideas before this startup, then I could see, I researched on ideas, I had a problems. And then when I showed that prototype in front of my prospect customers, I didn't get appreciation. Because that is something that was taking a lot of investment. That time I didn't have much thing to invest. Then I thought I have to pursue my job because I need ample amount of money. And then I gave time to me, myself, brought some money, and then I'm doing. So there's again, a lot of things are interconnected. You have to think in your situation, we're giving all this permutation and combinations.
I think, ma'am, all the students will get their doubts and their answers regarding the questions. Okay, I will hand over to Nidhi.
Yes, we are done with all the doubts, and thank you so much, Komal ma'am, for your valuable time and giving us such an information knowledge about choosing right career. It was very useful for us, and yes, it was a good experience which we all have throughout the session. Also, I would like thanks our principal, Professor Jatin Vaidya sir, and HOD ma'am, Mrs. Poonam Faldo ma'am, to provide endless support and motivate to take such a kind of initiative. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Nidhi. Thank you, Tesh, and the Pari University as well.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
जीते जीते जीते